Another video. In this video, we are going to discuss another SQL practice interview question, which is medium level of difficulty. So you can find this question on LeetCode, and the question says that we have a table employee, and employee has columns ID, name, department, and manager ID. So each employee has a manager ID, and if manager ID is null, then that particular employee does not have a manager. So no employee can be the manager of themselves. So this is one thing. Now what we want as the output, write a solution to find managers with at least 5 direct reportees. So if I am a manager, then I have to get the IDs of these managers who have at least 5. That means that there are 5 people under this manager. So first of all, let's see what the table has. So select star from department. Employee and run this. So this is what we are getting, and what we want is, so this is the input table. Now so I want the manager ID, and I want to understand how many employees are under that manager. So I need to count the employee ID, and I need to group this by manager. So for each manager, how many employees are under that manager, I need to count that. But at the same time, I will filter out all the rows, I will remove all the rows where manager ID is null. That is, that employee does not have a manager, so I will not take that manager ID into account. Okay, group by. I have made a mistake. Group by never comes before where clause. Oh, sorry. I should have. Let's do a check. ID is there. Employee name is correct. Now let's run this. And what I'm hoping from this is to get the managers, the manager ID, and the count ID is not null. And I should have put the condition as not null and not is null. Now I will get all the manager IDs and the count of employees under those managers. So I need the name of the manager as the output, not the manager ID. Okay, I want to have input, output should be the name of the manager, not the ID. So I say that it should be name of the manager, direct reportees. That means greater than or equal to 5. So I need the name of that manager, manager ID. I need the name of that manager, but in the table I have the manager ID, the employee ID, and the employee name. So I need to join this with the table. I need to join this. Suppose let's call this E1, and I will join this table itself, E2. It's a self join. The employee ID to ID in the second table, and it's an inner join because every manager in this table, every ID in this table will have also. Will also have a name and everything, right? So that's why we are doing inner join. And instead of manager ID, what I want is I want e2.name, the name of the manager, and then we are doing group by, like with the first column. And ID, it could be ambiguous. I want ID from the first table. Okay, and then let's run this. I'm hoping this time we'll get the right answer. Yeah. Okay, and we don't want this column. So so I'll just comment this. It is of medium level of difficulty. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.